And then there were 8. Welcome everybody here as we get ready for chase race number 7, the first race of the 3rd round of the chase for the Hershey's Cup Series Championship here in the Hershey's Cup Series Season 3. We are getting set here to find out who is going to be able to make it through today's race at Michigan, next week's race at Homestead Miami Speedway, and then the penultimate race at Talladega Super Speedway to be our final four to battle for this championship this season at the season finale of Auto Club Speedway. We are left with Cole Baker, Kat Tellier, Jake Baskinger, rookie Matt Haas, Dylan Poteet, James Richardson, Trent Dunham, and Kyle Matthews left to battle it out for this championship. Last week, after our second elimination race of this chase at Zendjoltis, we lost Blaine Keyes, Michael Norman, Cody Lamas, and Emmanuel Hartnett. Their championship road has come to a dead end, and they now are eliminated from competing for the championship, along with the drivers that were eliminated back at our first elimination race at Indianapolis: Dallas McIntosh, Jessica Shelton, Tim Walsh, and Zachary Fitzwater. So we've whittled our field of 16 drivers down now to 8, but only 4 will go on to Auto Club to battle for the championship. A win today by one of those elite 8 would automatically put them in a trip to Auto Club Speedway competing for the championship, regardless of what happens next week at Homestead and the following week at Talladega. You gotta bet that's on their minds. But there are 34 other drivers in this field. They all want to find victory lane as well here today, so it's going to be very, very interesting. Our Almond Joy Series race here yesterday went green flag for the entirety of the race. We even had green flag pit stops. Strategy like that could come into play into who's going to win here today. Future teammates line up on the front row. Anime Racing Team's representative of Nathan Hudson still looking for his first win of the season alongside of two-time winner Michael Norman, who was just eliminated from the chase. Let's get the command.
Drivers, start your engines!
And the reason that I say future teammates is because Nathan Hudson signing a deal with Michael Norman Motorsports next season to drive the 16 car. Michael Norman, of course, this being his final season, but Brooke Allen will be taking over the 3 car. But Nathan Hudson still going to be driving for Michael Norman Motorsports in Season 4. You want to see what your starting lineup looks like? You look down in the description of this video. We're going to look and make sure that everybody got going here on the start. It looks like they did. There's all the drivers that made it in via knockout qualifying. Pichu London, Cody Hagen, Lyndon Wright, Zachary Stoltz, Matt McIntyre, and Colin Denton, who started on the pole position for the Almond Joy Series race here yesterday. I believe out of those drivers, only 2 of them actually ran the Almond Joy Series race here yesterday. Hagen and Denton. So it'll be 30 laps of racing. As I stated, these drivers will not be able to make it the entirety of the race on the fuel they currently have in their race car, so they will have to pit. Question is, will they be pitting under caution or under green? We had no caution flag fly at all in our race yesterday in the Almond Joy Series. Will we see our first caution of the weekend here today at Michigan? They can hold them 3 wide, sometimes 4 wide, but a lot of times these drivers are not willing to give room, so we'll see what happens. The Elite 8 coming into this race, we don't really have to give you the points rundown because we told you the 8 drivers in the hunt for the championship, and with the points resetting for this round, everybody of those 8 drivers is tied up. So it's basically whoever gets the highest finishing position today is going to head into Homestead, Miami as the points leader of those 8 championship drivers still remaining. But here we go. Nathan Hudson, Michael Norman bring us down. Green flag is out. Chase race number 7 is underway at Michigan. There's Anthony McCurry stepping out of line back there. His teammate Cole Baker, chase driver, following him there. We're already 3 wide into turn 1. Nathan Hudson going to move immediately to the lead. Hudson, a former winner last season at Lime Rock, a track that we were at just a couple weeks ago. So it's been over a season since Nathan Hudson's been to Victory Lane trying to find his first win of Season 3. Here comes JT Bryant to the inside line. JT going to Victory Lane at Arizona. But his finish is not enough to get him up into a spot in the chase for the championship. So just trying to run for wins now is that 22 car. And now Leon Alvarez to the inside, and he's got a teammate behind him. So CJ Racing all of a sudden jumping up here to the front. With Leon Alvarez out in front, his teammate Chris Dodd there in second place, the defending Hershey's Cup Series champion, who will have to relinquish that title heading into season four, as he is not in this chase this season. Leon Alvarez coming into this race is 18th in the point stage, which technically is second highest of the drivers not in the chase. The only other driver that's not in the chase that's running higher than him is two-time winner Joseph Srigley, who of course had the win at both Lime Rock 2 weeks ago and last week at Zendjoldis. Back-to-back winner in that 24 car. Starting to see the urgency of track position here. Cole Baker is now up here battling for the second position, not too far back. Kyle Matthews in the 09, who, according, like I said, it's very hard to be able to do calculations in my head with the number of drivers that we had in the chase, especially being 12 drivers last week. And I thought that it was Kyle Matthews, one of the four drivers eliminated last week, but the calculators proving me wrong, showing that actually Kyle Matthews did manage to make it into the next round of the Chase for the Championship. So, you know, like I said, never ever leave anything to my brain and my mathematical skills, because more than likely they're going to end up being wrong. You got to wait until the official scoring comes in. And I think one chaser, yes indeed, Trent Dunham came to pit road. The Raynex Chevrolet coming to pit road, and that is not a good sign for him. I don't know if that's a regularly scheduled stop or not. He's now leaving pit lane, so maybe it is. And that's an awfully, awfully early time to be coming to pit lane. Now, the only thing I can assume is Trent Dunham's assuming this race is going to go clean and green all the way through. And when these drivers have to come to pit road, Trent Dunham's going to probably be able to stay out an extra, what, four or five laps. But he's going to right now fall a lap down to the race leader, so this is not good for Trent. Maybe he's, I don't know, maybe Trent's planning on the caution fly coming out, getting the lucky dog, because right now he would be the only car lapped down. There's a caution! Someone just went down towards the infield. That was Dallas McIntosh. Yellow flag is out, and that may be the caution to save Trent Dunham. Oh, we got a lot of cars back here in trouble. John Andrews, Joshua Michaels. We'll get to that in a minute. As at the line, Leon Alvarez leads it over Gallagher. Looks like Matthews may have gotten second, or third place, rather. Cole Baker in fourth, and Tim Walsh crosses the line in fifth. Incident, I think, happened out on two, and there were a number of wounded machines over in the turn three vicinity, as the field will now file in behind the pace car. There's John Andrews, and there's Joshua Michaels, both involved. There's the car I saw dart to the inside there on the back straightaway, Dallas McIntosh. Doesn't appear he has that much damage. Matt Haas is back here. And he just got run into the back of by Dallas McIntosh. Haas is back here, as is Cat Tellier. A couple of chasers not having a good start. Oh, Trent Dunham's got damage. Was it Trent Dunham that triggered that wreck? It could very well have been. Pit road is open. And I think Trent's more than likely going to have to pit with these leaders. He may still stay a lap down. Wonder if maybe it was something to do with when the one merged back up into traffic, if maybe that's what caused the wreck. It's only an assumption. We'll have to wait. Oh, Trent's going to stay out. Trent Dunham will stay out, so he'll get back on the lead lap now. Will the one? He may have actually caused the caution that gets him back on the lead lap. Oh, no. Leon Alvarez going to lead them down pit road here. Let's see if these drivers are going to go with any kind of strategy here, because the question is, with an early caution like this, are they going to be able to make it to the checkered flag now on this tank of fuel? I mean, fuel window. Oh, look out. Oh, Cole Baker. Contact there with Jessica Shelton on pit road, and Sean Galligan is going to be the first one off pit lane. Our Daytona 500 winner beats out Leon Alvarez, Joshua Ciculli, Jake Baskinger now up to fourth, so some strategy for him, as well as another chaser in James Richardson. So just like that, we've got about three, four chasers up inside of the top 10 now. But we're under caution. Let's take a look and see what happens. Sean Galligan will be leading us back to the green when we do get back green flag racing here at Michigan. Well, to be fair, this was not the fault of Trent Dunham. He comes up, he gives everybody room. Now watch the 10 car behind him. Well, I don't know. Maybe Trent didn't give enough room. Brandon Gonzalez actually getting a piece of this as well. We didn't document the 23 with any damage, but he did get a slight piece of this incident. And there is Joshua Michaels around, and look at the 17 of John Andrews never slowing down, and I think he just clobbers Joshua Michaels. Boy, Andrews thought he could drive through at full speed, and he paid the price. Wow. Well, oh, then we had another car right there. That's Dallas McIntosh, and oh my goodness, Zachary Fitzwater and Matt Haas narrowly avoiding the Cheez-It Ford. I guess that's the car I saw shoot down to the inside line. Yep, right there. Right there, you see. Well, they were three wide with Michaels, Lamas, and McIntosh. So I don't know if Trent really didn't give a whole heck of a lot of room there or not. But look at here, Dallas McIntosh gets shot right down towards the inside wall. He scrapes it the least little bit. And then he's going to come right back up the racetrack and, oh my goodness, right between Nathan Hudson and Cody Lamas. And that's a hard hit. That's like dead center, flat against the outside safer barrier with the passenger side of his machine. And look at this. Watch this. Fitzwater, Haas. My goodness, how did Matt Haas avoid? That could have been fatal to Matt Haas's opportunity to making it to Auto Club in this chase as a competitor for the championship. But man, let's go back to green, see what's going to happen here. We're under our first caution coming out here on lap number 5. We've gotten the signal, one lap to green. Sean Galligan out in front. Trent Dunham actually just came to pit road, and so he's a lap down again in the one car. We also have another car that is on pit road, and that is Michael Norman in the 3. There he is. Michael Norman in the 3 star on the outside of the front row on the pit lane. I don't know if that might have been due to some incident on pit road. Saw a number of drivers beating and banging on each other. Matter of fact, I believe if you look very carefully at the 73 car of Joshua Cipulli, I believe he's got a little bit of damage on the left side of his machine. So a lot of drivers end up getting some incident, you know, a little bit of contact there on pit row. You know, Cole Baker and Jessica Shelton made some contact, so don't know exactly what the case is there. After that incident, two drivers out of the race, Joshua Michaels and John Andrews. Trent Dunham is one lap down there. He'll start to the inside of Galligan. Michael Norman still on pit road right now, currently scored one lap down. We got 40 cars that are currently still on the track, still running. If you count Michael Norman, 38 of them on the lead lap. Top 10 as we go back to green. It's Sean Galligan, Leon Alrish, Joshua Cipulli. There's three drivers that are trying to find victory lane after a bit of a winless streak. Galligan hasn't been to victory lane since Daytona. Alrish hasn't been to victory lane since last season. Same for Cipulli. Baskinger is the highest running chaser, starting fourth. Joseph Srigley looking for three in a row. He restarts fifth. Then it's Richardson, Baker, Miles, Tim Walsh, and Kyle Matthews. Four of our elite eight starting up inside of the top 10 for this restart, half or one third of the way through this race, I should say, on lap number 10 of 30. Green flag back out. Trent Dunham going to try and get himself back onto the lead lap. Got himself a nice restart there on Sean Galligan. Now he's got to clear Galligan and hope for a quick caution flag. Look at Jake Baskinger wasting no time. Three wide for second place. And oh, four wide back there. They're leaning on each other. Baker and Miles and Richardson. And Baker and Richardson into the wall. A couple of chasers into the fence. Oh, look out. Oh, and Baker just gets wrecked again by Richardson. And here we go. Matt McIntyre around. Flickinger is involved. I think that was payback. I think that was payback between James Richardson and Cole Baker. Brandon Gonzalez is in it. Look out, we got cars coming to pit road. And that's a caution, and Trent Dunham did not beat the leaders back to the line, so he is not back on the lead lap. And Jake Baskinger will be the first chaser to be out in front here at Michigan today, and that'll be a valuable, valuable bonus point for him in leading a lap. But two chasers just got together, and the tempers seem to be flaring. There is what remains of Baker's No Man's Sky Ford Fusion. Carson Scott, Matt McIntyre involved, Flickinger. There is James Richardson in the 11. And boy, we're going to have to look at a replay of this, but I think Richardson just flat out dumped Baker, or Baker flat out turned up into Richardson after their first bit of contact. and that collected even more drivers on the back straightaway. We are under caution for the second time today. Big time championship implications in this one. Now here was the restart. They were really stacked up, and Michael Norman was actually a lap down trying to catch up. And they are, well, Norman really doesn't play much of a factor in this. They're just leaning on each other here. Benjamin Miles, Cole Baker, and James Richardson not giving a lot of room. And then Miles runs Baker up the track. Baker then gets hooked in the right rear. Both cars into the wall. Now watch this when they come to the back straightaway. I don't know if Baker felt that Richardson should have cut him more slack or if Richardson didn't appreciate it. Oh, wow. Okay, actually, I thought it was payback. It really didn't. I'm not so sure about that. Baker went down and he got sideswiped by, it looked like, the 20 of Colin Denton, who, ironically enough, is one of Richardson's teammates. Let's look back at that again from the helicopter view. I think the 18 had a little bit of help. Let's watch this. Let's go to the 18 of Baker. Now watch this. As they're on the back straightaway, Baker's going to come down a little. Denton comes up. And yes, oh, okay, so Colin Denton actually shot Baker back up into Richardson. I thought either Baker turned up purposely into Richardson or Richardson turned down, and there you see Carson Scott, Matt McIntyre both involved. Dylan Pote right there avoiding, and he's hoodless. I didn't even realize that another of our chasers had no hood. There's Flickinger involved. Jessica Shelton gets a piece of it as well in the 0-2. And just like that, the chasers begin falling one by one. Trent Dunham is down a lap early, damaged machine. Dylan Pote, we just realized now, hoodless. And Cole Baker and James Richardson, the cause for putting us under the caution for the second time here today at Michigan. Coming down to the start-finish line to complete lap 13, we should have the lights go out atop the pace car this time, so we should be back green flag racing at the completion of lap 14, going on to lap 15, which will reach us to the halfway point. Trent Dunham, you see there, and Michael Norman, both still a lap down. They'll go to the inside of the new race leader, Jake Baskinger. And Jake Baskinger, things looking up for him, especially in the fact that we've already had at least 50% of our Elite 8 get involved in something here today. You've got Kyle Matthews also hanging right there in the fifth position. So right now, things going very well for those two machines, and the fact that things are going very poorly for a number of their other chase competitors. Let's take a look and see who was involved in that wreck that retired from the race, and they include Zach Flickinger, Cole Baker in 38. So Baker really going to need a good run at Homestead and Talladega to battle back from this. Carson Scott and Matt McIntyre also out of the race. 34 of our original 42 are still on the lead lap. 36 drivers still running on the track. Jake Baskinger, the leader. Sean Galligan is second. Third is Joseph Srigley. Watch out for that 24. If he could pull off three wins in a row, I mean, we've already had a three wins in a row driver in the Almanjoy series, that being Kermika Jasmin. Srigley trying to do that. He won at Lime Rock. He won last week at Zonjoltis. You got Joshua Sequoia lined up there in fourth. Kyle Matthews fifth. And Zachary Stoltz, how about the go-or-go-home non-charter ride out of Fire Ice Racing? Sixth place running right now for him. Leon Alvarez back in seventh. Then you got NW Racing's Benjamin Miles and Cody Lamas eighth and ninth. And Emmanuel Hartnett completes the top 10. As we get ready to go back green flag racing here, we are only halfway through this race. Already we have had a lot of issues involving championship drivers, and it's not over yet. Green flag back out. Jake Baskinger gets us back underway. Baskinger looking for only his second win of the season for Fitzwater Australia Racing. Baskinger's only win coming at a dirt track, Bristol Dirt to be exact. Right now, as Sean Galgan has a little bit of difficulty with Trent Dunham, who appears to be up to speed, Jake Baskinger going to be able to clock out a little bit here and log some laps. Remember, Jake Baskinger is the only chaser so far that has led a lap today, so that's a bonus point he's got in his pocket. If he's able to stay out in front for a good majority, if this thing goes into a bit of a run, that's another extra bonus point he'll be able to put towards trying his journey to the Final Four at Auto Club. Might want to look in his rearview mirror, though, because here comes Kyle Matthews, the Kings Island Chevrolet. Kyle Matthews trying to get up there, get himself a bonus point for leading the lap. He's got a teammate not too far behind him there, Charles Samper in the Valvoline Chevy. And we talked about Zachary Stoltz, a go-or-go-home non-chartered ride, having a good run. Well, there's a couple more drivers that are working their way up here towards the front. See Lyndon White in the 81, Cody Hagen in the 46. Here comes Matthews. This is not for position, but he's trying to get by the lap machine of Trent Dunham in order to set his sights on Jake Baskinger. Teammate Charles Samper right there with him. Samper, a three-time winner last season, still looking for win numero uno here this season. Matthews going to try to the bottom on Baskinger. Baskinger can't throw the block, but he gets a nice run on the high side off of turn number two. Matthews going to try again here, going down to three and four, but now his teammate pulls alongside. Battle for second. Pole sitter Nathan Hudson still up here in this mix as well there, the Sailor Moon Chevrolet. And Matthews has to give up the second position to Charles Samper, who does a nice high-low cut to the inside of Jake Baskinger. And Samper is going to lead this lap. Nice piece of driving, getting the big run off the high side of four, cutting it down to the bottom, and getting the momentum to get to the line ahead of Baskinger. So Charles Samper now out in front here at Michigan. Let's document where our chase drivers currently are situated. We already know Baskinger right now in second, Matthews currently in fifth, but what about the other drivers of the Elite Eight? Trent Dunham, we already documented his early issues. Right now he is currently running, I believe, 39th. Nope, make that 35th. He is the first car one lap down. Jump back a little further, and that's where we're going to end up finding Matt Haas, there he is. Matt Haas is currently scored this time by in the 27th position, so not the best of runs right now for him. Good news for him, though, is some other drivers are having some struggles. There is Kat Tellier. She scored last time by in 30th position. There's Dylan Pote, hoodless. I gotta assume the reason that he's hoodless must have been something that happened on pit road. Pote last time by, he was scored in 32nd. There's James Richardson, got involved in that incident that puts under a second caution with Cole Baker. He's currently running in 33rd place. And then our other driver out of the Elite Eight is out of the race. That is Cole Baker, finishing the day out in the 38th position. So right now, out of our Elite Eight, only three drivers are running inside the top 20. No, actually two drivers are inside the top 20. Matt Haas is running back where? 27th, was it? Now he's back to 29th. So only two of our chase drivers are running inside the top 25 even. So you can bet Jake Baskinger, Kyle Matthews, if this stays the way it is, regardless of whether they win or not, they're going to be heading into Homestead Miami Speedway with a very, very good points cushion. That's going to make it very interesting. The points are going to be super close from third on down. Also worth noting, Cole Baker, I mean, with the fact that some other drivers are struggling, I wouldn't say he's necessarily heading into Homestead in a must-win situation. However, one of the tracks we're going to in this round, Talladega Super Speedway, our third and final elimination race, is a track Cole Baker picked up his only win of the season here in Season 3 at. He won the first Talladega race, so that could be a place where Baker could maybe mount a charge. Not sure I'd want to wait and rely on a Super Speedway race, though, especially knowing that that's an elimination race. Regardless of whether he goes to victory lane in 2 weeks or not, he still needs a good run next week, as do a number of other drivers. Kat Tellier, Matt Haas, Dylan Pote, James Richardson, they're all going to need good runs next week to counter what currently is looking like to be pretty dismal finishes for all of those machines. And of course, for Baskinger and Matthews, obviously they like the fact that they can maybe take a bad finish because of the good finish they had here, but I'll bet that neither one of them want to end up having to find themselves behind the eight ball heading into Talladega. If they have a good run here, have a good run next week at Homestead, they might be able to head into Talladega Super Speedway completely worry-free and be able to automatically say they're going to be in the final four at Auto Club. Right now, though, Charles Samper showing the way, and he has not looked back. They've been battling more for second place. Hudson in position, and he's got Chris Dodd trying to take the spot. Jake Baskinger, Lyndon Wright also in that mix. We saw earlier the high line was the best way to go. And And right now, everybody seems to be rather committed to that yellow line. And I think I just heard, yeah, we got traffic up ahead that these leaders will have to deal with. Dylan Pote, James Richardson, a couple of chasers, along with Brandon Gonzalez. And they are going to get caught here before this race is over. This could get very, very interesting. Lower traffic, damaged goods that these leaders will have to cut their way through. And you look here at the top three, they're drivers that haven't found victory lane yet this entire season. Samford at the bottom on Gonzalez. Now goes underneath of Richardson. Now we'll try to go underneath Pote, but Pote moves down and throws a block there on Samford. And that wads everybody up behind the 03 Valvoline Chevrolet out of Retro Racing Enterprises. Now Samford leads the charge there. Hudson follows in line. Chris Dodd, Lyndon Wright. Another slow car up ahead, that being Dallas McIntosh. And here comes Hudson to the bottom for the race lead. Will he get a pick here with the 16? Everybody getting wadded up, and Hudson, he uses the 16 as a pick, and he will go to the race lead. Here comes Lyndon Wright to the bottom as well. The DeWalt Ford Taurus out of WR Racing trying to take the lead, and he goes to the front. Now remember, we have had a total of, I believe it's three, I'm double checking. No, we've had a total of four non-charter go or go home drivers win this season. Joshua Osborne, Kev Shearer, John Bunnell, and Amore Stoudemire. Could Lyndon Wright be the fifth? And that just dropped Charles Samper all the way outside of the top 10. Here comes Baskinger for the race lead. Baskinger wants an automatic ticket to Auto Club Speedway. Trying to get to the inside, can't quite do it, is able to tuck back in line in second, but Baskinger wants to win this thing. He doesn't want to have to worry about Homestead. He doesn't want to have to worry about Talladega. He wants to go to Auto Club. He wants to head in those next two races completely worry-free, as now another chaser, Cat Tellier, going to go a lap down, courtesy of the leader, Lyndon Wright. Three laps to go here at Michigan. So flustered, I don't even know where we are. Top three have broken away. Wright, Baskinger, Chris Dodd. And you got Nathan Hudson still trying to catch back up. Sean Galligan, JT Bryant there as well. Look at Kyle Matthews, sense of urgency. Three wide here with Anthony McCrory as he tries to continue to fight his way up inside the top 10. Caution comes out now, the race will be over. Top three, Wright, Baskinger, and Chris Dodd. Two of these drivers have not yet found victory lane this season. One, however, wants a spot in the final four at Auto Club in the chase for the championship. Six more corners as they hit the back straightaway. If Baskinger makes a move, will Chris Dodd go with him and offer some drafting support? Chris Dodd seems a little closer to Baskinger's bumper than Baskinger does to Lyndon Wright's. Chris Dodd gonna peek out of line here on the 59. That's the battle for second place. White flag displayed one more time around. Lyndon Wright showing the way. Chris Dodd battling with Baskinger for second. That may give the win to Lyndon Wright, but I heard another car up ahead. That's Pichu London. London's not gonna be a factor. He just made a pit stop, the Advocare Toyota Camry. Now look at this, look at the gap. Three, four car lengths. Back to second place. Lyndon Wright through turns three and four. Another slow car, that's Dallas McIntosh. Will he be in the way? Lyndon Wright jumps to the high side. He'll clear him. Lyndon Wright sets sail for home. Lyndon Wright picks up his first win of his Hershey's Cup Series career, takes the checkered flag here today at Michigan. I don't know what it is with these non-chartered rides, but we have had a total of 33 races. And in those 33 races, five times, the checkered flag has been taken by a driver who made it in via non-charter knockout qualifying. John Bunnell did it at Bermuda. Joshua Osborne did it at Yas Marina Circuit. Amore Stoudemire Jr. did it at Chicagoland. Kev Shearer did it in Indianapolis, and today, Lyndon Wright does it at Michigan. Lyndon Wright gonna take a celebratory victory lap, well deserved. It's also the first time In Hershey's Cup Series history, we've had a Ford Taurus go to victory lane. All Ford wins have been Ford Fusions, but not today. Think about Lyndon Wright, the season he's had. Lyndon coming into this race all the way down, mired in the cellar of the point standings. He's only made 5 starts. Today was his 6th. Up to this point, I believe he only had 1 top 10 finish. And now he gets himself a victory. Standing should be official. Looked like we had some drivers have to come to pit road in the closing stages too. I saw Pichu London on pit road. Have no idea who else ended up having to pit. But Lyndon Wright, another rookie, goes to victory lane. That's our, I believe, is that our 6th rookie so far this season that has found victory lane? I believe it is. Amori Stoudemeyer, Kev Shearer, John Bunnell, Joshua Osborne, Matt Haas, and now Lyndon Wright. Chris Dodd will get 2nd today, Nathan Hudson in 3rd. But how about the performance of Jake Baskinger and Kyle Matthews? Baskinger will obviously be the points leader of the Elite 8 going into next week's race at Homestead, Miami. Was the only chaser to actually lead a lap today as well. He'll get 4th. JT Bryant gets 5th. 6th for Sean Galligan. 7th for Anthony McCurry. So a couple of the Seth Colbaker Motorsports cars having a good run. Chloe Erickson. How about that? We never talked about the 26 this entire race. Came up and gets a solid run in 9th. And Charles Sanford. Looked like it was maybe his race to lose and just couldn't get around the traffic that was up ahead of him. Got boxed in, but was able to battle back to get himself a 10th place finish. Kyle Matthews, as we mentioned, finishing there in the 8th spot. So both Baskinger and Matthews going to have a nice points cushion heading into next week. Let's see where the rest of your chase drivers finished this race. Got to go a long ways down before you find Trent Dunham. Who would believe a lap machine was the 3rd highest finishing chaser of the day. Trent Dunham, 28th place for him, and that's going to have him, ironically, 3rd in the championship points. Cat Tellier finishes in 29th, James Richardson in 31st, Matt Haas in 33rd, Dylan Poteet in 34th, and the only driver out of the race of the chase drivers, Cole Baker, finishing the day officially in the 38th position. Let me tell you what, folks, right here, my calculations on this one, I can calculate this. 10 points are going to be separating 3rd in the points to 8th in the points heading into next week at Homestead. There's going to be quite a gap if my calculations are correct. Jake Baskinger will have himself a 5-point lead over Kyle Matthews, and then the gap between Matthews and Trent Dunham is going to be a total of 20 points. That is quite a deficit in 2 races to have to make up. We'll have to see what happens next week at Homestead Miami Speedway, but I'm telling you what, those final 4 spots are going to be very, very hard to get, especially with the events that took place here today at Michigan. But Lyndon Wright finds victory lane for the first time in his Hershey's Cup Series career, and we have ourselves a very interesting scenario heading into our 2nd of 3 races in this 3rd round of the chase for the championship. Thanks everyone for tuning in to today's race. If you enjoyed it, be sure to give this video a like, subscribe to become a part of the crew today. We've shown you your full finisher results. Up next are your rookie point standings, your overall point standings, and your championship standings with your Elite 8 drivers. As I stated, next week, Almond Joy and Hershey's will be heading down to the beaches of Homestead Miami Speedway. Hope you'll tune in for that as you've been watching a production of the NCRA Offline Racing at its best.